Allah protect us. Because a zina, brothers and sisters, is a dangerous action. A zina is, whoever knows what zina is fornication. You know, when I come and I speak to you guys realistically, because this is a reality, especially the sisters, protect yourself. Protect yourself, I'm telling you right now. If you like that man, if you like that boy you want to marry, wallahi, tallahi wa billahi, do not ever let him do that with you. Don't, because the minute he does that with you, why does he want to even marry you anymore? Why does he want to marry you? What is your value with him right now? What is the value? What is going to push him to go speak to your parents now? What is going to push him to work hard so he can provide for you? What is going to push him to do that for? He said, I do everything with her anyway. Why do I have to work hard now? And then your value decreases in front of his eyes. I say that to you, and I'm speaking to you with reality. I'm speaking from a man's perspective. You have to value yourself. If you want to marry that individual, he wants to marry you, go the halal way. Go the blessed way. Wallahi, I'm married now. I have children. I have two children. I have a wife. I'm married now 5 years. I tell you what, marriage can be very happy, and marriage can be very, very saddening and tough and difficult. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلُوبْ بَنِ آدَمْ بَيْنَ إِسْبَعِينَ الرَّحْمَانِ أَوْ بَيْنَ إِسْبَعِينَ مِنْ أَصَارِ الرَّحْمَانِ يُصَرِّفُهَا كَيْفِ يَشَاءُ. The hearts of the son of Adam, our hearts, are in the hand, the two fingers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He sways the people's hearts however He wills. He sways the hearts however He wills. Do you think you are going to begin of the biggest chapters of your life, which is marriage, disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you think you're going to have success in your marriage? Does that even make sense? You're going to begin something that is the most of the biggest decisions and biggest chapters of your life and disobeying the one who controls your heart and his heart and will bless it if he wills or if he does not will. Does that make sense? It's like we're trying to do something. I don't blame the people all the way. I don't blame the young people all the way. Parents have to make it easier for us. But I'm saying this is your life. You're going to be the one to suffer in the future. How many marriages? How many divorces? How much heartache? How many young people are getting married and they want to get divorced immediately? But everybody sees the Facebook picture. It's all good. Right? Everybody sees the Facebook picture. And everybody says, what happened to them? I want to ask them, how did it start? How did it start? You see that? A horrible marriage, a quick divorce. How did it start? Because the people outside looking in, all they see is Facebook pictures. MashaAllah, she dressed up so nice, big walima. You know, they rented out a nice hall, whatever the case may be, whatever the people do. But all of a sudden they hear about divorce. What happened? She looks so happy. He looks so happy. How did it begin? What were they doing behind closed doors that nobody knows about? That's the deception of shaitan. So Allah says, وَمَنْ يَتَّبِ خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. And whoever follows the footsteps of the shaitan, فَإِنْهُ يَأْمُرُ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. The shaitan, he will command with all evil and all indecencies. So you think that you're going to get along with a woman, brothers, and you are not going to be tempted? Come on now. Don't ever lie to yourself. Don't think that you're that strong. Don't think like that. You think you're going to get along with a girl, or she thinks she's going to get along with a man, and then we're just going to talk? You might have, wallahi, you might have had the intention, and he or she might have had the intention before you came together, that we're just going to sit down and talk. But that's not what happens. The shaitan, the Prophet of Allah said, he said, أَلَا لَا يَخْلُونَ الرَّجُلْ بِمْرَأَةٍ إِلَّا الشَّيْطَانِ فَالِهُ. He said, surely, a man will not be alone with a woman except the shaitan will be the third of them. Except the shaitan will be the third of them. He will be enticing you. You become a different person. Your feelings and desires will take you over. And then at that time, you'll be in a drunken state. And after you finish, if you have any iman, you're going to feel bad. Why did I just do that? Especially the sister. She's going to feel disgusted for herself. Why did I do this for? Why did I lower myself? Huh? Why did I do it? You're going to feel bad and you're going to feel regret. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not follow the footsteps of the shaitan. Don't follow those steps, because the steps will lead to be worse and worse and worse until you fall into the greatest sin. And Allah says, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. لَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَةً وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. Do not go near zina. Allah did not say only, do not make zina. Do not fornicate. Allah says, don't go near zina. إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَةً وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. It is a wicked, wicked activity, and there's an evil lifestyle to live. There's an evil path to take. Nah. Wallahi. Wallahi wa billahi. I'm telling you right now. And today it became like being positive, being good, being a virgin. It began today, look how astray the people are. It began today that being a virgin and holding your virginity to marriage even became looked down upon even amongst Muslimin, waliyahu billah. Even amongst Muslimin, let alone the kuffar and non-Muslims. For a person to be a virgin, for a young woman to be a virgin before marriage, it's looked down upon. What have we came to? How far have we been astray? Wallahi, that is beautiful. That's a good thing. You're a young man, you're not married yet, you're a virgin, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Huh? You get points because you fornicated? You get points because you're a fornicatrix? Because you go around giving people these things, disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You get points for that? That's good for you? That's not good. That's going to give you heartache. That's going to give you sicknesses. That's going to give you distraction in your life. That's going to be disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you don't stop it, you can become addicted to it and you're never going to want to leave. Yes, fornication is addictive. You start fornicating, you don't want to leave fornication. And those people, they rarely get married. They rarely get married because they live in a life of fornication. Wallahi. And I had other things to speak about, but I'm staying on this topic because of the importance of it. But wallahi, brothers and sisters, we all have these desires, we have to take them out in the halal way. You like her, she likes you, go the halal way. Right? Go the blessed way, especially the sisters. Don't lower yourself. Don't let no man come and take what you have. Don't let him come and take that. He hasn't paid no mahar. He doesn't know your parents. He doesn't know your family. And he's going to take what you have, what Allah has given you. He's going to take that so easy. Oh, you're not cheap. You're not cheap. You're expensive. And you're not expensive in the sense of wealth. I'm saying, yani, you're expensive as, yani, you understand what I'm saying? Huh?